So our final steps would be now to create our texture, which we shouldn't have to do much of that. It's because we're going to project them on from our scan. So if you remember at the first thing that we did, we created this plane and we made two keyframes. This is why this is so important, because then it's going to make, once you've done this a couple times, you'll be able to blast through assets so quick just from scans. So if we turn on our position layer, which has got our plane, and that's kept the positions of our working position and scale and our projection for our texture scale. We'll always work in this scale, because if we scaled this down, we'd break our vector displacement, but for this it's fine, because all we're going to use it for is to create our textures. So if we select our base mesh geo, hold middle mouse click and drop it under the plane. Now if we go to the first frame, it's now, if you press F to frame it, it's now orientated itself to the position of where it is in meta shape. So when we recreate our textures, it will work perfect. So on the first frame, we'll press Shift P, and that will drop it outside the group, outside the plane, sorry, and pass on all the translations and scale. So now all I need to do is go File, Export Selection, and I will keep it in texture, and we'll call it, we'll make sure we don't get it mixed up, so we'll call it low res mesh text project. So we know that's the texture projection one of this model, so we'll export selection, and it should be fairly quick. And then we'll go back to meta shape, so you have your bread in meta shape now. Well, you have your scan. So what we need to do is, if you just go to File, import model, and if we go to our working folder and we put it in text and we call it texture project, we select open, and we want to replace the default model, so we'll replace that, and you see it's now, it's brought in the mesh, it's triangulated it, but we're not exporting this mesh out again, so it's don't worry about that. So now all we need to do is go to workflow, build texture. So we want to leave this as diffuse map, source state images, and you need to make sure it's on keep UV, otherwise it will do it on the ortho mosaic and break it. So make sure you have keep UV, and texture size account is completely up to you, depends on how close you want to do it. To be honest, most scans, they're pretty good, but you can have this up really high, but they're still not going to hold out really close there. Stuff like this is really good for like mid-ground, quick, fast assets when you're just powering through or just game stuff. But I'm just going to make an 8K texture, and you can reduce that in Photoshop if it's too big anyway. It's always better to have more than not enough, I guess. So we'll just do it as 8K. And this might take a while, so I'll probably fast forward through this. Cool, so that's now projected the textures onto our low res mesh. If we look around, we can see it's pretty good. We've still got these holes that we need to fix, but that's no problem. If we look around, check for any sort of crazy stuff, but it looks pretty good. So all we now need to do now is go to File, Export Texture. And we'll just go to our File. So we've got our texture from our ultra dense one already in there, but as you can see, this doesn't have the UV. So we'll call this SD low res mesh underscore diff VO1. our diff, and we will make this a TIFF. Save. The reason why we made it a TIFF is it's probably got, it will keep a bit more of the color data in there, and if we need to edit it, it's a lot easier than JPEG. Cool, so that's now done. We can now go back to Maya. So we've gone back to Maya. As you can see, our bread is at our projection angle. So what we need to do, we need to put this back under our plane. Then we can go to our second frame, and that's back to normal at the correct scale. So if we shift P that out, our geometry should all be back at one, scale one, and our translations rotate should be zero. And now we can hide that again. So if you go to your shader network, we've got our dome right here. So if you just select your standard surface, group and select that button there, and it will collate everything into this one separate area. So if we open up, if we go to the attribute editor, and we can select our AI standard surface, and we can go to color, and we can select the little checker box, go to file, there. Select our file, and we'll just navigate to our texture, and we have our SD low res mesh diff. And let's turn our filtering off. And it will come in as sRGB because that's how it, that's the color space meta shape works in, I believe. So that would be correct. If we left it on raw, we'll put it as raw so we can see what it, so you would know what it looks like if it's in raw. It won't look quite right, but yeah, it's good to know what doesn't look right, basically. So we'll turn off auto generate TX as well on that as well. And we'll probably change this in a second. And it's not. We probably should make sure everything's UDIM, but that hasn't got the UDIM namespace, file name. So we'll just leave that as it is. In fact, as we can see actually in the viewport, that's in the wrong color space. So just wait for the render, we can just go to the texture. And if you put it on sRGB, you can now see that's correct. So we can now go to our model render view again. You select render, update full scene. And it may take a while to update, but it shouldn't be, there should be no text TX being generated. And hopefully it should load any second now. Cool. So we're probably on the dark side right now, so. So we've got texture in now. Change our standard surface. Try and bring our weight up to one, so full range. Sorry, I'm just off frame. Just find a nice angle. Yeah, it looks pretty good. So there is one thing that we would need to do on this, because at the moment we shot it with some extra lights and on a quite a nice diffuse date, but there is, if we rotate around, there is some sort of shadow data in there. So our final steps would be to basically clean out those shadows in the texture, so it's a completely flat texture. So yeah, I'll save this, and then in our next one we'll clean out the shadows in the texture, and we'll re-import our new one in, and you should be finished. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, hit that like button and subscribe for more like this.